This here is a cucumber that has become pretty moldy, and before I throw it away, I decided to put the mold, the fungus, under the microscope. Hi, hello and welcome, Microbehunter here. And I did not only find, of course, the cells of a fungus, but something else which was quite interesting. I found lots of bacteria, which I'm also going to show you later. Preparing the sample is quite easy. As always, you take a small sample and you put it into a drop of water. Cover glass goes on top. And any excess water should be removed, of course, with a tissue paper. And this is what I saw. Those long, thin structures, these are the so-called the hyphae of the fungus. The hyphae of the fungus actually comprised the largest part of the fungus. And you can also see, if you look very carefully between the hyphae, between those cells, you can also see some occasional round structure. These are the spores. And the spores are reproductive structures. So they actually spread over the air. And when they settle down on a new place, a favorable place, then they all will also start to form a new fungus. A new hyphae will start to grow out of those spores. And this is how basically the mold is able to spread. So if you find some moldy food, immediately put it away, throw it away. Otherwise, it's going to infect the other food in your kitchen as well. Now, the thing that I also found are bacteria. And how are bacteria not different from the fungus that we have here? Well, there are several important differences. First of all, the size of the cells is quite different. Fungi are significantly larger. Some bacteria can grow also in filaments. However, the fungi also are branched, and bacteria that grow in filaments are not branched. So that's besides size, a second important criterion to distinguish fungi from bacteria. And of course, fungi are also able to form spores. Now, certain bacteria are able to form so-called endospores, which are able to withstand also dryness and sometimes also high temperature. But those endospores of bacteria actually can be found inside the cell. And the fungi here, what they form is they form very large spores, but that they are outside of the hyphae, and they can now spread over the air, maybe even over water, to other places to form a new fungus again. Now, bacteria are so-called prokaryotes. And this basically means is that they have no nucleus. They do not have a nucleus. And here, if you look very carefully, these small little dots that you see next to the spores and next to the hyphae, those tiny moving dots, these are bacteria. This also illustrates a little bit of the size difference that we have here. And those bacteria here, a little bit larger, have DNA, of course. All living things have that, but no nucleus. As a matter of fact, bacteria are significantly simpler. And in that sense, they also are not able to form more complex organisms. Like, for example, so-called eukaryotes are able to form. Eukaryotes are those organisms that have a nucleus. Here again, next to each other, you see again the long hyphae and spores, and they're significantly larger than those tiny moving dots, which are the bacteria. By the way, I've used phase contrast right now, and this allows you to see the bacteria much better. And simply the sheer number of bacteria here is quite remarkable. So on a moldy cucumber, you can not only expect to see mold, but also billions of bacteria that are growing there. And for this reason, I think it's a very good idea not to eat moldy food, but to simply throw it out, because you're not going to be on, what is this here? Look at this. Another little creature going through the screen here. Yeah, as I was saying, throw out your bad food, because you don't know what you're eating. And essentially, you do not want to eat the poisons and the toxins that the fungi and bacteria produce. So that's everything I want to share with you today. Happy microbe hunting as always, and see you around next time. Bye-bye.